No, they're okay. They're just curious. That was interesting. Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. Hello, welcome. And as you can see, the cows are out at the back of the house. I hope you can hear me okay. And I hope you can see me all right as well. Isn't that lovely? Look, the cows. We don't often see the cows, but when we do, it's always a nice surprise. Hello, moo cows. Hello, more moo cows. In fact, they're not all cows. Some of them are bulls. Anyway, would you like to see me? Okay then, I'm here somewhere. Hi everybody, this is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you feeling happy today? Yes, we are back with one of our strange live streams. I've just been into town and I rushed back because I wanted to do a live stream. I was going to do one from the town centre. I was actually going to stand in the town square, but I forgot to take my phone. Sometimes I can be very stupid. So that's what I did. I forgot my phone. So instead, we are going to do a live stream here in my garden. Just a short one, a short live stream. Say hello to the apple tree. There are lots of apples on the apple tree at the moment. Of course, here is my lovely gazebo. And you will also be able to see behind me the beautiful landscape outside. Just one moment whilst I set my camera up. Hopefully that will work properly. Oh yes, it looks as if we're okay. Very nice. Very nice indeed. So here we are then, we're back out in the garden and it is Friday. I don't normally do live streams on Friday, but today I am doing one because I felt like it. Of course, I wasn't with you yesterday. I didn't do one yesterday because we had a lot going on. Mr. Steve was doing his first performance last night, so I had to do some things for him. I had to make his meal and take care of him before he left the house. And to be honest with you, I didn't have time to do a live stream yesterday. But here we are anyway together. I hope you are okay. Just a short one. So this is only going to be a short live stream. Nothing too heavy, nothing too difficult. Just a lovely way to come towards the weekend. And of course, it's going to be a hot one. I'm not sure where you are, but here we are going to have a hot weekend. It is going to get very hot. I would say, in fact, it is very true, in fact, to say that it is too hot for trousers. It is. I should not be wearing my trousers today, but I am. I have my big, thick, heavy jeans on today. I should be wearing my shorts, but I'm not. So at the moment I am boiling hot. It is hot anyway. It is around 26 Celsius today, but this weekend it is going to get very hot indeed, because apparently it's going to be in the 30s on Sunday, maybe 32 or 33 or even 35 on Sunday. And then next week, Monday or Tuesday, it might get as hot as 40 here in England. And people already are going crazy over it. They are saying, it's too hot. It's too hot. 40 degrees. It's too hot. The strange thing is, I will share this with you now. The strange thing is, a lot of people go away on holiday at this time of year, and they will travel to places that are hot. However, if they stay here and the temperature is hot, they will think it is a bad thing. However, every year, lots and lots of people travel abroad. They will go to another country to enjoy the sun and the heat. Isn't that strange? So I suppose it depends on your point of view. Of course, on a serious point, and I suppose we should be serious, there are people who are vulnerable during this particular time. Elderly people, young people. So when it is hot, I suppose they will need extra care. There is an aeroplane going over, but it is no ordinary aeroplane. It is a large RAF carrier. It's one of those big planes that the trucks and the artillery can drive into the back of. Wow, that's a big one, very big one, flying overhead at the moment. I always call that particular plane the Brize Norton bus, because it flies normally from Brize Norton, which is an airbase here in the UK. So hello everyone, thanks for joining. I'm Duncan, that's my name by the way, don't wear it out. And I'm talking to you live from England. Apparently on the live chat, we have a lot of people talking as well, chatting, which is always nice to see. Hello Florence, Valentino, Sayeda, hello Sayeda, Nihal, nice to see you as well. We Claudia is here, Kanchan is also here. I have noticed that you are using my photograph on your profile. I've seen it. I suppose I should be flattered. I should be honoured by the fact that you want to have my photograph displayed on your YouTube profile. Hello Ahmed, Beatriz is here as well. We also have Juan Manuel. What a lovely garden, thank you very much. It's very kind of you to say. It is looking very nice at the moment. I was talking to Steve the other day and I said to Steve, the garden has never looked so good. I don't know why. This year, everything looks perfect. And of course, Mr. Steve enjoyed that comment very much. He was quite pleased. Hello also to Ahmed Bahar Aisa as well. Hello to you. Nguyen. Hello Nguyen. Nguyen watching in Vietnam. Hello Vietnam. Live now in England. And I have viewers watching in Vietnam. Claudia says, in Argentina, we will have holidays soon and many people will go where there is snow. Yes, I suppose so. There aren't any places at the moment here where there is snow because it's so hot. It's hot today. The sun has decided to come out. So yes, it is hot today here in England. But I think it will be quite hot at the weekend as well. Who else is here today? Oh, Masood Sharif is here. I am a big fan of you for a long span of time. Span. From going over there to over there. Span. Maybe one thing will stretch across. Span. To span something is to move across, go across from one place to another. Span. We often talk about a person's lifespan. That is how long something lives for. A human being has a certain lifespan. That is the length of time that a person lives for. You can be doing something for a long span, or a long period of time as well. It is possible to say that. Sandra Gonzalez is here today. It's very nice to see your rosy face shining from my screen. Sandra Gonzalez again. Hello also to Fawad. Hello, hello. Your side looks like it might be cold, but Luton is hot. I'm very interested to know what it's like in the southeast, because apparently that is where the worst weather is going to be. When I say the worst weather, I mean the hottest weather. So if you are in the southeast of England, that is the place, that is the area where it will be very hot indeed next week. Hello. Oh, Sandra says, very nice to see you, teacher. The best. Thank you very much. This morning I have posted a new Instagram video on my profile over there. I have been so busy this week. Hello to Abu Zid. Abu Zid Ismail Mohammed, who says, hello, Mr. Duncan from Sudan. Can I say hello to everyone watching in Sudan? It is so nice to see you here today. Hello also Masood, who says, I am happy to see you live. Yes, I am live. For those who are wondering, let's have a look. I don't know if you can see my watch, but yes, it is now approaching 4 p.m. It is approaching 4 p.m. in the afternoon on Friday the 15th of July. We are now officially halfway through this month. I can't believe how fast this month is going. And of course, as you know, if you are a regular viewer, you will know that my birthday is coming. I hope you will buy something nice for me. No pressure. I don't want to put any pressure on you. Well, maybe a little. But you don't have to buy anything nice for me. Oh, we have Luis Mendez. Luis Mendez is here today. I'm sorry, I was trying to do my echo. I can't do it today because I'm outside, but I tried to imitate the sound of the echo. Echo. That probably sounded awful. Hello, Franco. Franco Ferrari. I like your name, by the way. It is one of my favourite cars. Sports cars. When you see someone driving down the road in a Ferrari, you cannot help but look. You have to look at the car. Quite often sports cars, one thing I've noticed about sports cars, they are always bright colours. Orange, yellow, bright blue, or sometimes silver as well. I noticed that. I think if I had a sports car, I don't think I would have a bright colour because then it would be too obvious. I think then you would attract the wrong type of person, I think so, if you had an expensive car. So I think if I had an expensive car, which I don't, because I don't drive, there is very little chance of me ever driving a sports car, because I don't drive at all. I know it sounds strange, doesn't it? Alberto, hello everyone from Gran Canaria. Mild weather over here. Cannot complain, really. Well, it's not too bad here, but we are preparing ourselves. In fact, things are so bad at the moment. Here in England, we have declared a national emergency. Apparently, yes, it's never happened before. We are declaring a national emergency here because the weather next week is going to be so hot. Claudia. Yes. I suppose I should ask, what's cooking, Claudia? What have you got in your pot? What's cooking, Claudia? Is it something spicy and hot? Is it something salty or not? Oh, Claudia, what is in the pot? Brussels sprouts, apparently. You must be having something else. You can't just have Brussels sprouts on their own. You must be having something else. Maybe some meat, or maybe some other vegetables. Maybe some potatoes. I hope so. We went into town just before I started my live stream. Oh, Claudia says fried fish today with carrots and onions. That sounds quite savoury. I would describe that as maybe a savoury meal. I think so. Too much heat is no good. I agree with you. I think it is going to be quite hot over the weekend and also the beginning of next week as well. It's going to be very, very hot. So just before I started my live stream, Mr. Steve and myself went into town because Steve is taking a short holiday for a couple of days whilst he is performing in the show that he's doing. Anarchy! Hello, Anarchy! Hello also, Dewey, who is watching in Indonesia. Nice to see you here today as well. Florence is sending congratulations to Paolo for his song that he dedicated to me on Sunday. Did you see it? Did you see the song? Was it Sunday? Oh no, it was Wednesday. I'm getting confused because I've done so many live streams this week. I'm actually getting confused by the number of live streams that I've done. So that's the reason why. But yes, Paolo sent me a very nice song that he sang all about my live streams. And he was asking, Mr. Duncan, twice a week is not enough. We want more of Mr. Duncan. Well, this week you have been getting lots of me because I have been doing some very unusual live streams on my phone as well as my normal live streams as well on Sunday and Wednesday from 2 p.m. UK time is when I'm here with you. Very nice to see you here. Yes, before I started today's live stream, I was in town with Mr. Steve and we went to a small cafe, one of the small cafes in Much Wenlock. Mr. Steve had chili con carne, but he said that it was not as nice as his. I had something simple. I had soup, but it was very nice, homemade soup. It was lovely. So I did enjoy that very much. Claudia says, I like these live streams so much. Thank you, Mr. Duncan. Well, I always worry. You know I always worry. I am a person who sometimes worries, especially about this. I always worry that maybe this will be a little boring or tedious or maybe not interesting to you. So I often worry about whether or not this is interesting. I do. I worry all the time about these sorts of things. I take this very seriously, even though sometimes I do act the fool. I like to play the fool sometimes. Hello to the live chat. Yes, we have a lot of people joining in. Who else is here today? Oh. It's not good to be worried, Mr. Duncan. You are definitely the best teacher. Well, the thing that I find frustrating, and you know I always like to talk about things that affect me, and I always like to hear about the things that affect you as well. I worry about the fact that even though right now I have over 1 million subscribers, which is great, don't get me wrong, I appreciate it, but I don't often get many viewers for my videos or my live streams. And I've tried everything to do it. I've tried everything. So that's the only thing that really does worry me or annoy me. Because sometimes I feel as if the YouTube algorithms are being a little unfair. And a lot of people have complained about this over the years, not just me. So I'm not the only person complaining about this. Many other YouTubers, big YouTubers, have also complained about the fact that they don't seem to get the viewers that they probably should. It's just simple mathematics, really. If 1 million people are subscribed to your YouTube channel, you should get at least a certain percentage. A certain percent of people should be watching. So that is the only thing that annoys me sometimes. I think sometimes maybe the algorithms on YouTube are a little unfair. Maybe certain people are getting priority, or they are given priority. I've had a lot of messages asking about my YouTube award. Mr. Duncan, you have 1 million subscribers now. When will you get your award? My answer is never. I don't think I will ever get an award. I never got one for 100,000, and I don't think I will get one for 1 million. I don't think so. Alberto says, never boring. Mr. Duncan, you are never boring. Well, I try not to be anyway. Thank you very much. That's very kind of you to say. I am not looking for compliments. I'm not trying to find sympathy, but it is something that annoys me. It's very hard sometimes to let these things go from your mind. Yes. Oh, very nice. Fernando says, I've been following you since 2011. Wow, that's a very long time ago. Incredible. 11 years ago, watching. You watched me for the first time. I'm always interested to find out how you found me. How? A lot of people say, well, sometimes people will recommend me to you, which I think is very nice. Dewey asks, where are you, Mr. Duncan? I am talking to you now live from England. Sunny England. It's not too warm today. I think it's around 26, maybe 25 or 26 Celsius here today, so it's not really warm, and we have a beautiful breeze as well blowing by. One of the things I love about summer is the fresh summer breeze. Do 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 do. Summer breeze makes me feel fine, blowing through the jasmine in my mind. Lovely song. Well, not my version. My version is awful. But the song is very nice. Summer Breeze. Who remembers that song? Claudia is going now. I think Claudia is busy entertaining today. Enjoy your fish, your onions, your Brussels sprouts, and your carrots. Enjoy them, please. And think of me whilst you're eating them. Thank you very much. I am going in a few moments. This is just a short one today, just to say hello. I like to connect my phone to the internet sometimes and say hello. I hope you don't mind. Of course, I will be with you on Sunday. I might not be with you tomorrow. I don't think I will do a live stream tomorrow because it's Saturday. And also, guess what? I am going to see Mr. Steve perform in his show tomorrow. So I will be there watching Mr. Steve dancing and singing and acting on the stage. I might even though I've been told I can't, I might actually record some short video clips of Mr. Steve performing on a stage. I will see what happens, because I've been warned. I've been told that I'm not allowed to. But I might. I might record maybe two or three short video clips and show them on Sunday. We will see what happens. So I won't be with you tomorrow, but I will be with you on Sunday, definitely. You see? Definitely. I don't like this hand. This hand looks weird on camera. It looks strange. It doesn't look like a hand. It looks like something else. This hand looks great. I think this hand is okay. Looks okay, that. That's okay. But this one, weird. It looks all strange. This one, okay. This one looks like an old potato. I will see you on Sunday. Don't forget the time, 2 p.m. UK time is when I'm with you next. Hello. There's a little bird behind me in the bush, just behind me over there. There's a little bird singing away. Thank you very much for your company. Yes, I will see you on Sunday. Hope you will enjoy the rest of your day as well. This is just a short live stream just to say hi. And now I am saying bye. Catch you later. Enjoy the rest of your day. Enjoy your Saturday as well. And you can watch this again with captions later. Definitely. Thank you very much, Valentin. Thank you, Florence. Thank you, Beatriz. I'm glad you like it. And I'm also happy to hear that you're not bored with it. Which always puts a smile on my face, to be honest. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of English saying thanks for watching me for this short time. See you on Sunday from 2 p.m. UK time. And of course, you know what's coming next. Yes, you do. Take care, everyone, and stay cool. And of course, ta-ta for now.